welcome to Q&A Tuesday, where I answer all your questions on neuroscience, the nervous system, and the vagus nerve. And this week's question says, why do I find it so hard to make positive changes? And sometimes I move into fight or flight or into freeze when I try and create new habits. And this is an excellent question that we can answer when we look at the set point of the nervous system. So just like a temperature set point, you can consider your autonomic nervous system in the same way. So let's say we have an optimal set point, which is like the optimal temperature of a house, and that's where we feel the most comfortable, and it's almost like the same with the nervous system, where this is the optimal set point where our physiology, our mind and our thoughts and our emotions is functioning optimally as well. And this set point can be changed. It can be changed by your past trauma, so periods of chronic stress or things that have happened in your past that can move that set point so that it's more likely to go towards hypoarousal or hypoarousal. But it can also be influenced by what it is you do on a daily basis. So let's say a lot of your work involves multitasking, or you're often making many, many decisions that can lead to you feeling overwhelmed. Say you do a lot of screen time, all of these things, overworking, overdoing, can move that set point. So let's say the set point now becomes up here. And then we would actually have our speeding up of the nervous system and calming down moving in to this area here. Now, at this set point, we'll say this is suboptimal. So that means that we are more likely to have our physiology in a state closer to fight or flight. So that new set point is going to have an effect on our digestive system, our immune system. It's going to affect our hormones. It's going to move all systems into a state of dysregulation. The problem is the set point that we are familiar with is the one that we're likely to come back to. So even though it may be suboptimal and not quite so good for us, we tend to move to a state where the nervous system is familiar with, even if it's not that great for us. So then when we try to move into a state where we're calm and we're relaxed, there can be a sense of tension or resistance because the nervous system's not familiar with being in that state. It finds that the set point that feels more comfortable is the one where there's higher arousal, tension, and anxiety. And you may actually seek that out by being on your phone more or doing more, because that's a more comfortable state than not doing quite as much. And this can be true as well for things outside of our life. Say, for example, if you're used to growing up in a house where there was chaos and there was drama, and you get into a relationship with somebody who's nice and calm and steady, and it's a healthy relationship without all the chaos, that can feel boring, or it can feel uneasy because your nervous system is used to having chaos and drama. So it's important that we tap into what it is that's our nervous system driving us, and what it is that's our deepest values, or what we actually really want. The set point being higher makes it harder for us to create change, because say we want to do something like begin to eat healthy or try and lose weight, the nervous system creates a tension when it's something new because it's not familiar, and that tension or resistance can be what stops us from carrying on with this. So the key is we want to bring that set point back down so that we are at a more optimal place where our physical health, our emotional and cognitive well-being can all thrive. So we can utilize practices in the body to do this. When we tap into bottom-up processes, we can actually have the best result at changing the set point of our physiology. So for instance, you can tap into what we call the heart rate. So we can use heart rate variability, which actually has a positive effect at changing the brain. And this way, we're more likely to move to a state that supports our health and it's more optimal and it builds emotional regulation. And when we practice this enough in a way that we're encouraged and we're supported and we have the right tools and techniques, we actually set a place, a new place of what's familiar. And this then is what we'll go back to. So rather than going back to the place where stress is normal, overdoing is normal, and there's a lot of resistance and a lot of ill effects on our health, we come down to a place where our nervous system can be a little bit calmer and our whole well-being responds to this. So I teach this all in the Vagus Nerve Program, which is coming up on May 25th, so if you'd like to be a part of it, you can. And thank you so much for everybody who submitted their questions to Q&A Tuesday. I love getting your questions, so feel free to submit them again and I will do my best to answer them for you. Thank you so much for watching. Take care. Bye.